Welcome to the One Minute Apologist. We interview the world's leading apologists to provide credible answers to curious questions. Welcome to the 1 Minute Apologist. My name is Bobby Conway. I am here with Jeff Kinley, who is a very gifted author and also a friend. And it's great to have you on the 1 Minute Apologist, Jeff.
Great to be here, Bobby.
I know that you've got a book out right now entitled As in the Days of Noah. How apropos is the timing of that in relationship to the movie Noah? Tell us how you decided to do this book.
Well, really at no other time since the days of Noah is the whole world talking about Noah again. And so knowing that this movie was going to come out, I said, you know, there's a great idea for a book and also some great things for our generation today from Noah.
Was it an interesting study for you as you got into it yourself?
It was huge. I just buried myself in my study for about 2 months solid, and I provided over 450 footnotes for readers in the book to help them see some of the research and to help them dig in for themselves.
And as you've watched the movie yourself, what are some of your initial reactions to the movie?
Well, I think, you know, the story of Noah is an epic story and demanding an equally epic movie. But when I saw the movie, I find myself hoping that it would get better and better, but and on the whole, it ended up being a misrepresentation of who the person of Noah was and the whole event. The core message may be hidden somewhere in there, but it's not plain.
Sometimes what you hear from skeptics, and I'm sympathetic to it, you know, if you can hear, well, oh, come on, you really believe? I mean, this, you know, guy builds this ship and the rains come, and they can say it in such a way that you almost feel foolish. But how would you explain to a Christian, if you were just trying to give them a little bit of an apologetic of, hey, you know what, this is something that really did take place in history?
Yeah, well, we see over 300 flood myths, or flood stories rather, in all of history. And that tells me that there's a common thread running through history and civilization. But with that, combined with that is the words of Jesus himself, where he told his disciples, it will be just as in the days of Noah when my second coming happens. And so Jesus believed in the flood, he believed in Noah and the historicity of that person, and so did his disciples growing up in the Jewish culture.
Jeff, thank you so much for coming on the program, and I wish you all the best with your book.
Thank you.